Like Mikey said, have Bob Arum call us. Simple as that. We're not too far. Mikey doesn't have a promoter, so it's an easy fight to make. It's just, if he really wants it, we could do it.
So do you think? So what are your thoughts behind? Like, I mean, I'm personally curious because you know the commentators throughout his whole fight, they just kept saying how like Sosa, correct? How he was the only one who would step up to the plate. So is everyone like ducking him?
HBO is good at that. They're good at.
I mean, they had me believing. No, I was like, whoa, everyone's scared of him.
They made the whole world believe. You know. Even though they are very good, I'm telling you, you know, like Chocolatito or Triple G, they are very good. They are good. Skills-wise, you know, they're good. But they have the whole belief like they're unbeatable, like those guys are untouchable. You know, that's the way HBO does they blow up their fighters, and it's true. But there's other fighters that are as good or even better, you know.
So basically, no one is avoiding him right now.
At 126 or 130, there's just nobody out there for Lomachenko. It's not that nobody wants to fight him. You know, some of them are different promoters. Some of them are fighting their mandatories. So it's not like nobody wants to fight him. You know, it's just the fact that at that moment those fights are not available. You know.
That makes sense, because if somebody else is lined up or, boxing, yeah,
you
know, okay.
Lomachenko, I'm fighting, you know, nobody wants to fight me, everybody's afraid of me. In boxing, that's not.
Do you think is he the one who's actually saying that, or is it more like the whole, like.
No, I think he is, because he believes in himself. He does believe in himself, and he is very talented. You know, I still haven't seen the fight.
You didn't watch the fights?
I was at some fights.
Oh, look at, you're like, I was at the fights.
I've seen it. No, we're at the fights.
Other fights, of course.
And Alex Bozdik found that card, so I really wanted to see his fight because, you know, I used to train him and now I'm not with him, but, you know, I'm still supporting him 100%.
Yeah, it's Alexander, so, but we say Alex.
Yeah, so I just seen little clips, like, I think Pita showed me little clips of Mean Machine and also Bozdik. I haven't seen the fight, but right with that's all I wanted to see when we were working. The Lomachenko fight, I'll watch it on my own maybe tonight. But I'll see it. I haven't seen it yet. But look, let's just be real. Lomachenko looks sensational. His skills-wise is unbelievable. He's probably got the skills like, you know, they're comparing him, maybe Pernell Whitaker. I don't even know who else they're comparing him, but Pernell Whitaker. Pernell Whitaker was his own man, too. At that time when he was fighting, he was hard to hit. He was unbelievable. Lomachenko is I could say similar, but not really the same style. Lomachenko is something that we haven't seen before. Just like Pernell Whitaker was something we hadn't seen before. Just like maybe Rigondeaux was something we haven't seen that much. You know what I mean? Or a few years back from Dominican Republic, ¿cómo se llama? Juan Guzman. Unbelievable skills too, Juan Guzman. But Juan Guzman was never an HBO star. So HBO is really good at that. Honestly, it's true. It is true. HBO is really good at that. You know, going back to Chocolatito, they had Chocolatito as pound for pound the best fighter in the world. There's two fighters in his weight division that might be better than him, and nobody even mentions them. HBO don't even mention Estrada or Inui. They don't even mention, and Inui for sure will beat the share of Chocolatito, I think, right? And they don't even mention him. But what? But Chocolatito's number one pound for pound. Why? Because HBO says so. If HBO says...
How do you get HBO on your good side like that?
Well, because they're with HBO. They're signed with HBO.
Oh, I see.
That's why.
We could send them some Hawaiian chocolates, huh?
Because they're fighting on HBO.
What's up with HBO.
And they're good at what they do it perfectly.
Hell yeah, they do. Because there's people like myself who aren't obviously as well educated, you know, in the whole boxing world. Like, I like what I see. And of course, you guys inform me, but.
Well, at least you admit it. There's other people with a camera that know shit about boxing.
No.
But they think they know it, you know what I mean?
Yeah, no, well, and I get curious, you know, because like with Lomachenko, obviously they said he, as an amateur fighter, he had over 300 fights.
Only lost once?
Exactly, and now as a professional, I believe now this
he
is.
Lost once.
Yeah, he also lost once.
So he's beatable too.
And that's right? where I'm like, that's where I'm confused. I was like, wait, but he already lost. Like, so exactly. how is he so untouchable if he already lost?
They make you believe he's untouchable.
But I had my doubts, and that's why we're talking.
And look.
And they even say yeah. too that he's not a power puncher.
And he fights Sosa, right? Sosa only had like 2 amateur fights. You know that, right?
Yeah. Sosa fucking sucked.
Dude, which is crazy that he only started boxing at the age 21.
And he
29.
Only had 2 amateur fights. Exactly. So, like I'm telling you, they put him on HBO and he looks unbelievable because he does have unbelievable skills. But against Sosa, who only had 2 amateur fights, started boxing at what age did you say?
He started boxing at age 21. He was working at like a pizza joint.
Okay, so see what I mean? So let's not go there, okay? How many rounds did it take?
No, like he... 10? Yeah, 10. 10 rounds. I believe it was 10. 10 or 11.
Okay, Sosa against Mikey.
Fucking 2 rounds,
maybe? 2 rounds. Mikey knocks Sosa out in 2 rounds. But whenever Mikey wants, cold. You know what I mean? Sosa is not even compared to Mikey. But it's... You know, it's just like the way they're talking. It makes it good. It makes it interesting for the fans to enjoy a great fight.
We all need some hype people like that, right?
Yeah. It's true.
Well, Ellie's good at that, actually.
Yeah, Ellie's good.
Ellie can make you believe anything. He's really good. Ellie, if you're listening, you're really, really good at that. I believe everything you say.